Magic in the morning. We're very pleased to have Dan Stevens with us on the show this morning. The Beast in Beauty and the Beast. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for coming in. People will know you as the very dapper Matthew Crawley in Downton Abbey.
Yes.
And other things, of course. But now you are the Beast.
Other things other than dapper, you mean?
Or, yes. Yeah. No, you know, you're just very dapper. I mean, very smart. I've also got to ask you before we move on, what's that? You'll need to, if you're listening now, have a look at the video on Facebook.
Imagine, if you will, a coffee mug, a travel coffee mug, but it's shaped like a horn.
Right.
That is what I'm holding.
Why? I mean, why are you holding it?
Because I like coffee.
Right. And does it make it taste better? They say that if you drink tea from a China cup, it tastes better.
It has a certain kind of...
Or make the coffee taste better.
There's a sort of horny quality to
it. Well, perfect. We have a horny, sexy beast.
There you go. Horny Matthew Crawley.
Very good. Your beauty in the film is Emma Watson.
There she is, sorry.
You have to wear this incredibly large beast-like suit for the whole thing. That was quite a tough gig. Was it heavy?
It was about 40 pounds and it was quite thick and sort of bulky. And I was on 10-inch stilts for all of the Beast's performance anyway. And so I felt pretty beastly.
Was there a fan in it? Was it hot?
They had a cooling vest. I was trying to get in shape for the end of the film. There was a reveal, obviously, of the prince.
The prince, yeah.
And we shot a version where the prince emerged from a bed of rose petals, very American Beauty. I was topless. So I thought, right, I'm going to, you know, I've got to get in shape for this. Disney prince emerging from roses. And so put the hours in at the gym, got all ready, and they shot the thing. And they showed it to some test audiences, I imagine in the Midwest somewhere. Mm. And more than one mother said, well, if he's naked from the top down, then he must be naked from the bottom down. I am not taking my daughter to see this. And we had to reshoot the end of the movie with me clothed.
Have you got a trained singing voice?
I do now. Yeah. I mean, I've always kind of learnt on the job, really, for everything I've been doing, and it's been a fascinating journey. And it's when you sort of come up with things like that, and you think, oh God, right, okay, this is a new something else I need to sort of learn sharpish. And I got together with an amazing voice coach at the Royal Academy of Music here in London, Anne-Marie Speed, who just is a brilliant, brilliant woman, and just kind of gets through to idiots like me how to sort of engage the muscles of your voice without kind of any, I don't know, there can be a lot of weird language around sort of voice training. Like, imagine you're a butterfly and you're flying, and it's like, that's not helpful. I'm just trying to sing a song here. But she really kind of,
It's about the diaphragm, isn't it?
No.
No. Oh.
No. It comes into it, but it's more up here and muscular. And so I was kind of, you know, working on the interior muscles as well as the beastly muscles as well.
You had a great beast voice.
Thank you very much.
That obviously went through some kind of processing, wasn't it?
Can
you do your beast voice
kind of
now?
Yeah, it sort of came out of the... So they gave me some fangs. They made some fangs for me to kind of...
A bit of a lisp.
Well, just to explore like what it would do. I just wanted to sort of feel... Because so much of it was unreal. We were making it all with CGI, you know, motion capture and facial capture. I wanted as many real touchstones as we could have, right? So they made me this amazing pair of fangs that are literally, you know, they're made by, I think he is a dentist, basically, and he does, you know, regular sets of teeth, but he also, he does, you know, fangs to order as well, I guess. And so he gave me this, that looked like I've been born with them. They were incredible. And I get to keep them because they don't fit anyone else, and they sort of break them out on Halloween. I was sort of, you know, playing around with these things and thinking, well, how would a very sort of vain, arrogant, dapper prince who'd been, you know, cursed with these hideous teeth, how would you try and hide them and start, you know, you sort of find a way of talking. And he's quite posh anyway. And he's, you know, a lot of posh people talk out the bottom of their mouth anyway. And it sort of came out of this thing where, you know, you tilt the voice down, the larynx starts to go a little forward. And
eyes closed. You sound like Richard Madeley.
Richard.
What makes you beastly in real life?
Hunger.
Yes, hunger.
Not enough
hunger
coffee.
Thank God we've got the horn.
Thank God we've got the horn.